words of announcement I want to make. First of all, the administrative board, we will try for September to meet in the parking lot. We're going to go ahead and just receive reports via email for the month of August once again. I appreciate you helping Gail. She's feeling much stronger, but we want to wait till September when she's 100%, and then we'll plan to meet out here in the parking lot and have our admin. Second thing, too, is next Sunday. You might recall Mother's Day offering in the woods. I've personally gone up to Blairsville to tour the facilities, and I've always said that I don't plan to get old, but if it should happen, I'm going to retire in Wesley Woods because they do a great job. You'd be happy for your mom and dad to be there. So that's a ministry we have that needs a little support every year, and that's something we get to do. So if you would like to, your free will offering for Wesley Woods, bring that or send that for next Sunday, and we'll forward that to Diane Vaughn, a very dear lady from Marietta First, who is leading that ministry. Also, I wanted to say, I forgot last week, thank you so much. Let's give a hand to Bill, Kurt, Jim O'Brien, and Ollie for building this platform to help us for the next few months. I appreciate them. And the sound system is just, we're almost 100%. So, and also, Flo, thank you so much. I was telling Joe and Deb a little while ago, this reminds me of Elizabeth Taylor and Cleopatra. It's pretty fancy right here. Very nice.
Our hymn of praise this morning is Be Thou My Vision. Those gorgeous words are in your bulletin. There are three verses written there. Rashida and Jan will be playing it for us, and we'll only be playing two, but I encourage you to read all of those words. They are so rich, and sing them in your hearts and minds as they play for us.
Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is the one true church, apostolic and universal, whose holy faith let us now declare. We believe in God the Father, infinite in wisdom, power, and love, whose mercy is over all his works, and whose will is ever directed to his children's good. We believe in Jesus Christ, Son of God and Son of Man, the gift of the Father's unfailing grace, the ground of our hope, and the promise of our deliverance from sin and death. We believe in the Holy Spirit as a divine presence in our lives, whereby we are kept in perpetual remembrance of the truth of Christ and find strength and help in time of need. We believe that this faith should manifest itself in the service of love as set forth in the example of our blessed Lord, to the end that the kingdom of God may come upon the earth. Amen.
Good morning. We have received a lot of prayer petitions over the week, and I'd like to share those with our church this morning. And as I share them, we'll pause together and we will respond. Lord, hear our prayer. The family of Shane Ward. hear our prayer. Barbara McCain, who is fighting COVID, Lord, hear our prayer. Reagan is a little 5-year-old going through chemo. Lord, hear our prayer. Nick Shreve, who is recovering from surgery. Lord, hear our prayers. Kelsey Spain. Lord, hear our prayers. Ron Bonner with Alzheimer's. Lord, hear our prayers. Jack Boyd's family in the death of his brother. Lord, hear our prayers. Mario and Rachel. Lord, hear our prayers. President Trump in the death of his brother. Lord, hear our prayers. Ray Wells, who's battling COVID. Lord, hear our prayer. Tom Lutton. Lord, hear our prayer. William Whitaker. Lord, hear our prayer. Moose Whitaker. Lord, hear our prayer. And Miss Todd, with possible amputation. Lord, hear our prayers.
Thank you, Susie. And now we come to the time of pastoral prayer. Let us bring before the Lord all of our concerns, but also our praise at this time. And Holy God, we present to you our offering of praise. You are a God who is good all the time. In you there's no shadow of darkness, no turning. We give you praise and glory in your house. We thank you, Father, for this place to worship. We ask you, Holy Spirit, to come and speak softly but definitely to our hearts and our minds. We need transformation. We also need encouragement. Lord, you know all the things that we need and individual needs today. And so we ask your blessing. We pray for health for those that are sick, for recovery. We pray for peace for those who are troubled. We pray for love for the fellowship of your church and for the demonstration of the witness of Jesus Christ to the world. We pray for patience. We pray for strength. Lord, we pray for our leaders in this nation and for our nation, that there will be a turning back to God, that there will be a time of coming to you for salvation, for deliverance, and for wisdom for everyday life. Guide us in all decisions. Help us to follow the path that you set, for then we will be prosperous and successful. Then we will have peace. So we ask you to lead our steps in the coming days and months. We pray for a full recovery from COVID-19, for ourselves, for our town, our state, our nation, and the world. And we pray that in all of this, you will be glorified, for we are the church of Christ and the sheep of your hand. We bless you, Almighty God, and we pray and lift our voice together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
Good morning. Our scripture this morning comes from Genesis chapter 45, verses 1 through 15. It is a great story about Joseph and his family, and I thought it was very appropriate today because we're all members of this great Hopewell family, which we have found out over the last couple of weeks as Gail has gone through her situation with COVID, and I do want to say thank you for all of that. Then Joseph could not control himself before all those who stood by him. He cried, "Make everyone go out from me." So no one stayed with him when Joseph made himself known to his brothers. And he wept aloud, so that the Egyptians heard it, and the household of Pharaoh heard it. And Joseph said to his brothers, "I'm Joseph. Is my father still alive?" But his brothers could not answer him, for they were dismayed at his presence. So Joseph said to his brothers, "Come near to me, please." And they came near, and he said, "I'm your brother Joseph, whom you sold into Egypt. And now do not be distressed or angry with yourselves because you sold me here, for God sent me before you to preserve life. For the famine has been in the land for these 2 years, and there are yet 5 years in which there will be neither plowing nor harvest. And God sent me before you to preserve you, to preserve for you a remnant on earth, and to keep alive for you many survivors. So it is not you who sent me here, but God. He has made me a father to Pharaoh and the Lord of all his house, and ruler over all of Egypt. Hurry and go up to my father and say to him, thus says your son Joseph, God has made me lord of all Egypt. Come down to me. Do not tarry. You shall dwell in the land of Goshen, and you shall be near me. You and your children and your children's children and your flocks, your herds, and all that you have. There I will provide for you, for there are yet 5 years of famine to come, so that you and your household and all that you have do not come to poverty. And now your eyes see, and the eyes of my brother Benjamin see, that it is my mouth that speaks to you. You must tell my father of all my honor in Egypt and of all that you have seen. Hurry and bring my father down here. Then he fell upon his brother Benjamin's neck and wept, and Benjamin wept upon his neck, and he kissed all his brothers and wept upon them. After that, the brothers talked with him. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Change my heart, oh God, make it ever true. Change my heart, oh God, may I be like you. Change my heart, oh God, make it ever true. Change my heart, oh God, may I be like you. May I be like you.
Thank you, Becky. That was such a sweet song medley. We appreciate that. And great help in worship. You know, the breeze and the cool. Now, you got to understand the difference between my wife and I. She likes hot, hot, hot weather. I like the fall. I like the winter. I like cool weather. So driving up this morning, I said, I think I feel a season change coming on. She said, now you know it doesn't even stop being hot till September. So maybe we both have a little bias, and maybe it is wishful thinking on my part. But I would say that change is good. But one thing we as Christians have is the sense of the sweeping of the Spirit. When God sweeps through our lives and brings change. Now, of that, I will confidently speak more so than the weather today. I sense the Holy Spirit working through the life of our church, but also the nation. And so our prayers continue that we will see change. That as we go through this process, and as we live through this once-in-a-century experience, that God will also bring with us change, change that we need inside. Hopefully many have had opportunity to come to reflecting on their priorities and what's most valuable in life. And perhaps we will all find that we still can easily get caught up in things not so important. So I'm thankful for the sense of change. I'm thankful, too, for the sense that we are moving through. This time will not last. It will not endure. We will get past it, and that time is coming soon. So we're so thankful for God's care through it all. Today, surprised by God's presence, someone who knew about change, someone who knew about transitions of life, sometimes dramatic transitions of life, and then the wonderful, supportive, and revealing presence of God at important and critical times in his life. That was Joseph. And so the question comes to mind, we should not study Joseph where we don't remember that there is some kind of foreshadowing. You would have to be foolish not to see the foreshadowing, a picture of the Christ to come in the life of Joseph. There's a biblical discipline known as typology. Like every other approach to Scripture, we have to be careful that we don't overemphasize things in Scripture that there's a balance in the way that we view Scripture. But it is hard to miss typology. It's hard to miss that God was presenting in consistency with his own character and with his plan that no one can thwart. No one can stop the hand of God, not for eternity, not for the plan of mankind and their salvation, not for you and not for your family. I hope you feel encouraged by that this morning. God has both a destination for you, big picture stuff, as well as little destinations. He also has the determination he will bring it to pass. Life is challenging at best. And so we find that in this sense of looking back on Joseph, there's a lot to learn. And we don't want to impose too much, but we don't want to miss what's here for us. The covenant patriarchs given to us as an example. Given to us as an example, reveal that God's been revealing aspects of his ultimate plan of salvation in Christ through those he sent before Christ. We learn a lot about the human condition, the situation with sin, the need for salvation, and God's plan as we look at all of the Old and New Testament together. All of these, Adam, Noah, Abraham, Moses and David, they all find their relationships with God and their covenant with God and God's covenant, more importantly, with them, fulfilled in Jesus Christ in the inauguration of the New Testament. It was all fulfilled, but it was certainly reflected, foreshadowed in the life of Joseph. In Joseph, we see perhaps the most powerful type, to use that word, type, of Jesus, the picture of him and who he was and his ministry. We find more in that with Joseph than we do all of these others. One thing is consistent with all of these from the beginning. And now remember, Moses wrote the first five books of the Old Testament. We call it the Pentateuch, the first five books. And so he begins Genesis. We have a powerful conflict between Cain and Abel. And this is after the fall into sin. And we see that this continues. There's Jacob and Esau. There's Noah's sons and their conflict between themselves. Abraham had Ishmael who threw himself against Isaac later, the son of promise. And so there was Isaac and Ishmael.